Hi there. In this quick video, we are going to take a look and test this LiitoKala Lii-500 charger. So I ordered this thing a few months ago. It arrived a few months ago, but I just didn't have time to tinker with it. These are the specs, and from what I could see online, everybody is happy with this particular product. It seems to be quite well made, and it does the job it's required to do. Let me just tell you why I'm buying this thing. I have a nickel cadmium and nickel metal hardened charger, pretty good one, but I decided I actually would need a lithium ion charger because I work a lot on laptops. If you check out my channel, you will see that that's mostly what I do all the time, and batteries from laptops do fail. I've tried to revive a few of them by charging them with standard phone charger. Weird things, do not ever do that. Just to jumpstart them a little bit so the laptop will charge them again, didn't work. But the last time I had something to do with that, I think there were four cells. Yeah, I think there were four of these cells in a battery. And I sold that to somebody at my workplace for $2. And I talked to him. Okay, he had something like this: if they have some capacity left, you give me the $2. If not, we will recycle them. We have a recycling bin for batteries and accumulators and whatnot at work. And he actually tested them on his charger, and three out of the four were above at almost 2500 milliamp hours, so they were almost as brand new cells would go for that particular model, and only one of them wasn't charging at all, no matter if he tried to jump start it, whatever he did, it wasn't charging. So that particular battery I could have saved just by replacing that one cell, but instead of that I sold three good accus to somebody for $2. So yeah, I think they were Samsung or something like that, pretty good cells. So I decided, working on laptops, for sure I will get bad batteries like this one is, and now I can actually see which of the cells is bad in it and replace it with a good cell from another laptop battery, or simply go online and buy only one cell and replace it. Or I can do even better than that. For example, I have these Chinese power banks. I can actually open them up, test the cell inside to see how much it can hold in, and replace this with better cells. For example, this thing, it says 10,000 milliamp hours. This thing doesn't have nearly as much. So now I can actually test it, and I know it has who knows what. I could test it via the USB, obviously, but that will not only give me the capacity, because there are some losses inside. So yeah, I prefer to do it this way. And yeah, it's handy. In these days, most things will start to work with lithium batteries, so this is good to have around. And this will be the first one that we will actually test with it. This needs to be fixed, it has a bad USB. And then you will see also this thing working in a separate video where I try to revive this particular battery. These three are working, so I will do nothing to them, they are in good condition now. This has a bad USB port. This will be again a separate video at some point in time, but we will do this now. Let's open this thing up and see what we actually get here. Packaging honestly seems simple and well made. Good enough. Good enough. Nothing special, but it doesn't feel flimsy. The cable is, at least the exterior is thick. We do not know about the wires, impossible to know unless you open it up. It does annoy me when we have scotch tape holding things together, because you cannot remove it without ripping this thing apart. But probably it's cheaper than using stuff like this. So I can understand why they are doing this, but it still annoys me. Yeah, has a decent amount of weight to it. 12 volts, 2 amps. Yeah, I can believe that. Cable again thick, but I don't know about the wires inside. Instructions. Yeah, maybe you can read that. I can't. But we do have the English variant on the other side, although not even sure if it's for everything. Yeah, anyway, there is some English in there, so probably we can deal with it. Nothing else in the box. Again, the variant with the scotch tape. And this is way bigger than I expected. My other charger for nickel metal hydride batteries is about this big for 4 batteries. So this is quite huge. But yeah, it seems it will take any size of nickel metal hydride in here. And obviously these things. This is the info on the back of it. So let me just unpeel this, because I never leave. That feels nice. I never leave stuff covered. Yeah, quality control. You can see specks of dust. See, it's not the best quality control out there, but should be good enough. So let me read a bit about this thing and how to power it on, so we can give it a test with this particular battery, which obviously I will prepare before, meaning I will rip these things out of here. Come on, little battery, you can do it. Yeah, this doesn't want to rip easily, so I need pliers or something. Good enough. Good enough, it will make contact. And my phone ringing in the background. Yeah, we can test this thing. I'm expecting it to be almost dead, but we will see. Just wanted to add that they did use this I don't know, wire method for this. So probably it was just easier for them to use scotch and made more sense in that particular situation. So, yeah, sorry. And another thing I did wrong. It seems today I'm not too good to film. I looked at this thing like this, and when I turned it around, it was like this. Didn't realize this was missing. So yeah, Chinese, English, we have all the instructions, let's read them. Must love the Chinglish. There is a little fever when the charger is charging and discharging. I think they meant heat. Anyway, good enough, I can understand what's written here, but it was a bit funny. Getting ready to test this battery. I just want to see if it actually has any voltage left, at least. It actually does. So we are at 3.6 volts. Almost 3.7. So this is our positive. And this is how we need to put this thing in. This is plugged in. We get null on the display. And it detected it. And by itself it went into the charging mode. At 500 milliamps, milliamp hours. Or milliamps, because in the book for charging it gives us in milliamp hours the charging current. I don't know, probably should be milliamps only. Anyway, let me read this thing a bit more because it explains things a bit too complicated, so I probably need to play around with it to understand better than from this. I understood most of it from this. The most important thing, it can charge different capacity cells, different size cells and different chemistry cells. So you can put one lithium, one nickel cadmium, one nickel metal hydride. It will deal with them without any issue. So let me play around with this thing and come back with an idea if it's easy to understand or not. But from this it's not quite easy to understand how it should actually be programmed. How you choose the charging current and whatnot. Discharge current, whatever. Yeah. It seems it's quite easy to understand. This overcomplicates things. So, let's say you want to charge this lithium battery and this nickel metal hydride battery. Null when there is nothing plugged in. Make sure you see the proper polarity, but if you insert it the wrong way, I think it will give an error. It has polarity protection, so no worries about that. Let me just test that polarity protection, but I will test it with this, not with with the lithium variant, because I don't like fires for the moment. But I don't think I made the contact here. Yeah, so it will do absolutely nothing. It doesn't try to reverse charge it like a dumb charger would. Okay, let's put this in. By default it goes to charge and you can set your charging current. So it has 300 milliamps, 500 milliamps, 700 milliamps and 1000 milliamps. I will go to 500, which is also the default. You can fast test it. In a fast test, it will give you the capacity of that particular cell. It will discharge it to zero, and then it will charge it to the maximum. Or, as you can see, when it's not flickering, you need to hold on the mode button a bit more, then it will flicker again. In normal testing, it fully charges it, then discharges it, and then fully charges it again. So it's a bit more accurate. So, I'm going to do a fast test on this thing with 500 milliamps. If you choose 300 milliamps or 500 milliamps for discharging, it uses 250 milliamps. If you choose for charging 700 milliamps or 1 amp, it will discharge it at 500 milliamps. So I'm thinking I will go for this because I have no idea how good this cell is and I don't want to break it, damage it, whatnot, because maybe in my particular case, maybe this was the fault. I'm not sure. I did not test this with anything. I didn't have anything to test it with until now. So this thing is doing a discharge at the moment, and yes, it might heat up. Okay, after it finishes the discharge, it will start to charge it to see how much it can put into this battery. Into any one of these, you can plug another chemistry and it will detect it by itself. So you do not choose the chemistry, it chooses the chemistry. And again, it will default to charging at 500 milliamps. But again, we want to do on this thing, we hold longer the mode button and we want to do a fast test at 500 milliamps. Yeah, I think that is good. So we have fast test on channel 4 and fast test on channel 1. And we wait. Yes, I don't think it's ideal to do a test, a normal test or fast test on 4 of these cells at 1 amp. Probably this will heat up when charging and when discharging. But like I've set it here, shouldn't be absolutely any problems. So yeah, I'm going to let it do its thing and come back to you with an answer. I'm quite curious, and if it heats up at these rates, if the cells heat up, it should have temperature protection, overcharging, over discharging protection. So it's this little thing, it's quite smart. I really do like it. Especially the fact that it's really user-friendly and it can detect the chemistry by itself, and it will choose a charging current somewhere in the middle. So it's easy to use for anybody. You simply just plug it in and put in the batteries and it will do the rest. If you don't want any fancy stuff and choose your own currents and whatnot. And that auto chemistry detection, I think it's quite nice. I don't know if it's better to do it by itself or make you choose it, but if you choose it wrongly, you do more harm than good, so I think automatic is good. I don't know how it will deal with bad cells that are below the lithium voltage, that are that bad that they are almost at this voltage. I've seen that. I don't know if it will recognize them as lithium. That remains to be seen in the future if I get a bad cell at that particular badness level, if you can say it like that. So yeah, quite like it up until now. So the NA loop was almost empty and it's already charging it at 500 milliamps, and it already put 10 milliamp hours in it. And this is, it's 1 minute since it started to charge it. I'm curious how much it will have in the end. It should have 1900 milliamp hours, but these are a few years old. I haven't really used them quite correctly, so probably they will have less, but how much less, who knows. This one still discharging it, and it might take a while. Probably I should have chosen a higher current, but I do not know how good this cell is, so better not risk it. Forgot to tell you, this thing can actually be used as a power bank. So it's able to draw current from the cells to give you 5 volts via USB out, which is quite nice. And it also has defective cell protection. It limits the time it will charge a nickel metal hydride. And overheating, reverse polarity, obviously short circuit, and overcharging and discharging. Good. Also, it shows the internal resistance of the particular cell. From what I know, if the resistance is too high, that cell will drain quickly and it's Ganski. So yeah, not sure if it also uses that to detect a bad cell, but could be. You can see it's obviously different between lithium and nickel. Decided to bump the current a little bit. these things did not become warm at all. So I'm going to go for the full amp and see what happens. As you can see, after it started to charge, it will not allow you to change the current. You need to long press the mode. When that is blinking, you can change the current. And I think if we press like this, no, it has an 8-second timer, and when that ends, you have the 100 milliamps. And now I think it will again start to discharge it. It to reset everything. So let's go here for the full amp. You can see the voltage going back up when the discharging stopped, and going back down when it started again. And I think we just finished discharging this thing, and now it started to charge it. Yep, so it was almost finished discharging, and when we raised the current just a tiny bit, it cut off. So now this thing is still discharging because we actually put some current in it. Yeah, at this charge level, it will also use 500 milliamps for discharging. So this is probably less exact, less accurate, but I don't need anything that perfectly accurate. So let's see what it will do. This is what I was charging my nickel metal hydride accus with. Pretty good, I really liked it. 4 channels independent, temperature sensors here. It could take AAA or AA or AAA, simpler to say like that. But AAA only 2 at a time, AA 4 at a time. Again, all 4 channels independent. This was really heavy. It's the type with a transformer inside, so that was annoying. Also had this to plug it into your car. Never used it obviously in the car, and I was thinking to keep it so my wife doesn't charge I don't know, this type of cells with the voltage or settings from this type. But seeing that this does it automatically, I will sell this. No point in keeping it anymore. So yeah, quite happy about this thing. It seems it's mistake proof, or at least it seems. Who knows, we'll see over a few years if it is so or not. As you can see, this finished, and this particular cell is complete crap. 139 milliamp hours, it's all that it can hold. Maybe if I do this test once again on the lowest settings, maybe it will show a bit more. Maybe it's just unable to provide the 500 milliamps that it this takes when discharging if I set it to charge at 1 amp. But no, this seems to confirm the fact that I knew that this thing is crap and it's gone, and it actually is. And this one still going strong, and probably it has a bit more time to charge fully, so I will let it continue. It seems something really weird here. Battery activation without any volt. This thing is able to wake sleeping batteries. Awesome. Okay, it's brand new and I'm already abusing it. This cell is really bad. As you can see, 68 milliamps in the second test, so this is not holding any charge. It needs to be recycled. The NL loop above spec, it should have 1900, and it has 2381 milliamp hours, which is pretty cool. And as you can see, I have weird wires going here and charging these two in parallel, because this is the way they were designed or made to be charged in this particular Lenovo battery. So yeah, and it seems to be going quite nicely up until now. I was able to jump start this because they were 0.06 volts. Now they are at 3.5 volts almost, but I needed to jump start with something externally. This didn't like it, tried to jump start them, but it tripped the protection in it, so I'm forcing it a little bit by jump starting it myself. But yeah, it is working, so this thing is awesome. I need to say that I really really do like it, and as you can see, already misusing it. So yeah, if you want to see this video, I will put a link in the description. If I forget, just ask me for it and I will update the description. So as always, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed it, in which case maybe give it a like, and see you in the next video. Bye. As bonus footage for anybody who stayed this much, I bought recently this thing from China, and it came with a really weird accumulator in it. Doesn't even say the capacity anywhere. Charging time 3 to 5 hours, so you charge a lithium cell by time. And high capacity, and it says the voltage and 18650, so the type of cell. Nothing about how much charge this thing will take. So I decided that maybe it's time to find out exactly how much this thing can take. Didn't quite make it in. Okay, so we will change the mode to fast test at 700 milliamps, and yeah, that should be it. So let's see another Chinese accumulator, and still charging the laptop batteries right there, which are Sanyo cells, and I think they are 15 years old and still taking a charge. So this Chinese battery seems to have 1231 milliamp hours. So let's get it out of here. So yeah, it's pretty weak, but yeah, gets the job done, what can I say. And as these cells go right here, we already put in them just trying to put this back together. Let me just give it a quick bell. Whoa, yeah, good, working. We already put 3749 milliamp hours, but that's not all of it, because I changed the charging current, and when you change the charging current, it resets the milliamp hour reading. So I reset it once when it had about 100 milliamp hours, and the second time when it had about 300. So this is over 4000 milliamp hours in these two cells right here. So either one of them is really good and the other one a bit weaker, or both of them are really good. But anyway, I'm considering that I'm pushing my luck, and it's better not to charge them any more than this, because the electronics might know how to deal with these two batteries being charged in parallel. This thing has no idea that it's charging two cells, and obviously it's unable to monitor the temperature of the cells, and this one starting to heat up, not too much, but it is starting to heat up. This one a bit less, but they both of them are a bit hotter than the ones which are cold, the ones that are not doing anything. So yeah, that's about it. I'm quite done with charging these things. Yeah, so Chinese, cheap Chinese stuff and reused stuff that is bottom of the barrel, don't touch them. But you can actually get reused good batteries, so yeah. But this time for good, this is the end of the video, so thank you for watching and bye. Forgot to tell you, so not the end of the video. Once again, forgot to tell you, I already sold my other charger to a friend because I like this one so much. This is awesome to see exactly how much it's charging, all the information from the batteries, everything. Yeah, this is really, really, really good. And it doesn't heat up too much. So, nice. Bye for good this time.